The New World Order, that is to say the One World political system written of in Revelation chapter 13, will not come into being until the woe of the fifth trumpet, which is when Satan and his angels are cast from heaven to the earth by Michael and his angels, as you can read for yourself in Revelation chapter 12. And that's when Daniel chapter 7 begins with those four beasts rising up out of the sea, which is symbolic of peoples, multitudes, nations, and tongues. One government made up of four components, four being the number of earth. There are four directions and there are four seasons. A global, one-world political system made up of the lion, which symbolizes the Christian nations, the bear, which is symbolic of the communistic, non-Christian nations, the leopard, which represents the Kenites and their four hidden dynasties, the infrastructure of this one-world political system being education, economics, politics, and religion, and last but not least, the fourth beast, which is made up of the supernatural, Satan and his angels, the locust army, written of in Revelation chapter 9. This one-world political system receives a deadly wound, and as it's written in Revelation chapter 9, verse 12, one woe is past, and behold, there come two woes more hereafter. Why? Because the woe of the fifth trumpet is that political beast, and at that point it will have been wounded to death. The woe of the sixth trumpet is when Satan appears as Antichrist, and it becomes a one-world religious system from that point forward until the return of the true Christ. At the seventh trumpet, the final woe trumpet. And you can read of these three woe trumpets in Revelation chapter 8 and verse 13. But once Satan appears at the sixth trumpet as the false Messiah and heals the deadly wound by convincing the world that he's Christ returned, and as it's written in Revelation 13 verse 5, and there was given unto him a mouth speaking great things, and this is written of almost verbatim in Daniel chapter 7, speaking great things and blasphemies, saying that he's Jesus, and power was given unto him to continue, that's the key word, continue, 42 months, which is now 2.5 months, with the original 7 years being shortened to 5 months. You'll also see the word continue in Revelation chapter 17, verse 10, speaking of the exact same fixed moment in time where it says, and there are 7 kings, 5 are fallen, and 1 is, and the other is not yet come, and when he cometh, he must continue a short space. That's 2.5 months. At the sixth seal, the sixth trumpet, and the sixth vial, Satan shall continue. Only from that point forward, he continues in his one-world religious system as opposed to his one-world political system. Satan continues from that point forward, midway through the 5 months, because he had already been on earth 2.5 months prior to the sixth trumpet. As it's written in Revelation chapter 13, the dragon gave that political beast his power and his seat and great authority. And that word seat in the Greek is thronos, and the fifth vial is the deadly wound because it's poured out upon the seat of the beast. And after that, Satan appears as the false Christ, and that's the woe of the sixth trumpet. So once Satan appears as Antichrist in Jerusalem, he must continue a short space. And this is even that silence in heaven about the space of half an hour, half of 5 months being 2.5 months. And we see that word space in both Revelation 17 verse 10 and Revelation chapter 8 verse 1. There's also a space for repentance written of in Revelation chapter 2 verse 21, which also speaks of this last half hour of the hour of temptation, during which the whole world whores after Antichrist, except for those with the seal of God in their forehead. And the reason there will be silence in heaven about the space of half an hour is really quite simple, and you'll find it explained in Revelation chapter 6, beginning with verse 9. And when he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God and for the testimony which they held. Verse 10. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, How long, O Lord, holy and true, dost thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? So this isn't silence in heaven. This is the souls of them that were slain for the word of God and for the testimony which they held, crying with a loud voice, saying, How long, O Lord, holy and true, Dost thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? Verse 11, and white robes were given unto every one of them, and it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season, until their fellow servants also and their brethren that should be killed as they were should be fulfilled, delivered up to death, that is to say, not killed literally as these were, but delivered up to death, and death is one of Satan's names. And why are they delivered up to death? Because it's at that time that the Holy Spirit will speak through them, as you can read of in Mark chapter 13 and Matthew chapter 24. So that's why it'll be silent in heaven at that time, because they will be observing the delivering up of God's elect, at which time the Holy Spirit will speak through them. And notice it said a little season. A season is about 90 days, 3 months, that is to say. That's awfully close to 2.5 months as far as a literal season is concerned. Summer, for example, is between June and September, which just so happens to fit into the term of the locust. Something you may want to consider, especially since summer is used by Christ in Matthew 24 as an analogy for the end, harvest time, and the end of the generation of the fig tree. We don't know when the 5-month-long hour of temptation will begin, though, because it could happen at any time of the year, be instant, in season, and out of season. As Christ said in Matthew 13, the harvest is the end of the world, and as he said in the last verse of Mark chapter 13, what I say unto you, I say unto all, watch. The Gospel of Matthew is the latest installment of our audio Bible study series, and not only does it contain all 28 chapters of Matthew, but also the 7 seals of the apocalypse as the 8th disc of this set, and an even more in-depth analysis of the 24th chapter of the Gospel of Matthew, whereby you can familiarize yourself with the 7 seals as taught by Christ just prior to his death, burial, and resurrection. 8 audio CDs, $30 donation. Write Mark 13 Records at mail.com to find out how to order the Gospel of Matthew.